there, folks. Mr. G here with another educational video. This one we're going to be talking about buying versus renting versus leasing. Now, you're probably familiar with these first two words, buying and renting. You might not have heard of leasing before, but these are the kind of words you might encounter if you want to purchase something very expensive, like a house or a car, and you can't afford to pay for it all right away. Most cars, if you want a brand new one, is at least $20,000 or $30,000, and unless you have all that money saved up, you're going to have to make some decisions about how you want to set up your finances so that you have access to that car, whether you want to buy it, lease it, and same thing with a house, whether you want to buy it or rent it. So your first option when you want something expensive that you can't afford to buy out all at once, like a car or a house, is to buy the item and then take out a loan or a mortgage, in the case of a house, to pay for that item. The advantage here is that once you pay it off, you own it. So it's now your car, it's your house, it's your property, and you can sell it, and you never have to pay again once you pay it off. The next option is that you can rent it. And usually this only applies to a house or apartment. You don't really rent a vehicle in the same way. Usually renting a vehicle is just for a few days or a few weeks at a time. Here we're talking about renting a house or an apartment. When you rent a house or an apartment, you pay a monthly amount, same as you would for a loan or a mortgage, except you don't own it. You'll never own it as long as you're renting it. You keep paying every month or you have to leave. Whereas with a mortgage or a loan, after you finish making all of your monthly payments over however many years, you own it and you don't have to make monthly payments anymore. The last option is that you can lease it. And this only applies for cars, really. You don't lease houses. Just like a rent, you pay a monthly amount. It's very similar. What's different about leasing is that usually at the end, you have the option to buy out the car. The idea with leasing is that this monthly amount takes care of the depreciation, the lowering of the value of the car, along with some interest. When you buy out the car at the end, this is called the residual value. It's basically however much the car is worth by the time you make it to the end of your lease. Now you'll notice all three of these options, leasing, renting, and buying, all include a monthly payment. However, the mortgage and loan payments tend to be larger than your rent or lease payments. So when it comes to mortgage or loan payments, you own it at the end, whereas renting it, you'll never own it, and leasing, you have to buy it out at the end. So you're really still buying the car. Mortgages and loans tend to be better long-term investments and are good if you plan on sticking with the same house or the same car for a really long time. Renting and leasing are better if you plan on changing where you live or what car you drive more often. It just gives you a little more flexibility, but you're not working towards owning the property. The money that you pay here are really just covering interest and maintenance costs. You're not building up any property or any capital by renting and leasing. Whereas with a mortgage or a loan, you will own it at the end, which means you'll own the property, you're building up your property and your capital. Let's start looking at some specific examples of leasing versus buying. In this case, we would be talking about cars. Now, the book has examples of leasing and buying, but their examples try to be very realistic and go through exactly how the calculations would be done in the real world, including all the different taxes and how those taxes are being applied to down payments, lease payments, loan payments, and the buyout amount at the end. And because they're trying to be 100% realistic, it's a little more complicated than I think is helpful. I'd ask you to skip those types of questions and I'll show you a question that's a little bit simpler, but really shows the main idea here without getting caught up in all of the small detailed calculations. So let's say Brian wants to buy a new truck that costs $35,000 total, including tax. And he has two different options. One, he can buy the truck, makes a down payment of $7,000. Let's say those are his savings. He takes out a loan for the rest at 8.2% per year compounded monthly and makes monthly payments at the end of each month for 3 years, so he pays it off. His second option is to lease the truck, making $700 monthly payments for 3 years, and he's given the option at the end of those 3 years for a buyout of $16,000. Our first question here is to find the monthly payment amount if he buys the truck, and we'll compare it to the lease amount. This is something we can use TVM to solve. So let's hop over to our spreadsheet. To figure out his monthly payment he has to make to buy the car in 3 years, we know the rate is 8.2%, we know the number of years is 3 years. The amount he's taking out his loan for is $35,000 minus the amount that he saved, which was $7,000. So he's taking out a loan for $28,000. He wants eventually to pay off his car, so the amount on the loan he wants to eventually be zero. The effective rate, this is happening monthly, so we would take our annual rate and divide it by 12, Same thing for a number of periods, except for we're going to multiply by 12. We know our present value needs to be positive. That's the money he's taking out from the bank in order to pay for his car. And now we can use TVM. We're solving for the payment. So we'll do equals PMT, open bracket, click on our rate, number of periods, present value, future value, and we were told that he's making it at the end of each month, which is a zero, close the bracket, hit enter, and we get $880. Now this might look a little bit strange, it looks like it's exactly $880, but if we add some decimal places here, it just so happens that the rounding works out. Now this is a negative amount because he is making payments, this is coming out of his pocket, going back to the bank in order to pay off his loan. Now comparing it to the leasing amount, which was $700, this is more than the lease, which is what we would expect, because at the end of our loan payments here, we own the truck. At the end of these lease payments, we do not own the truck. Part B asks what the total cost of the truck is for each option if he wants to own it by the end. That means for our lease, he would be taking the buyout at the end for $16,000. Hopping back to our spreadsheet, for option A, which is the buyout option, this would be equal to the amount that he paid every month times the number of months that he paid, and we'll multiply by -1. But this is actually less than the amount for the vehicle. So clearly we're missing something. If you remember at the very start, he had $7,000 of savings, and that also counts in the total amount that it costs to buy the car. So here we would also have to add another $7,000. That makes more sense. The original cost was $35,000. He paid about $3,600 in interest. Now for option B, he made the same number of monthly payments, but this time it was $700 each month times the number of months, which is 36. But he also needs to buy it out at the end for an extra $16,000. So we'll add that in and we'll see this is the amount that he would pay if he wanted to lease and then buy the car. Notice the amount for option B is quite a lot more than option A, almost $3,000 more. And this is the drawback for leasing. Generally, it will cost you more money in the end to lease a vehicle if you want to buy it. But you do have the option at the end of those 3 years not to buy the vehicle at all. So it gives you a little more flexibility. However, that means that this $700 per month was kind of like a rental fee. So you're not building up any capital or any property or any value by paying that $700. You don't get to keep it, you just get use of the vehicle. Question C asks us about how much he would have to save up each month into an account with 5% annual interest compounded monthly in order to make the buyout in 3 years' time. This is a lot of what people do when they take a leasing option, is they'll save up some money every month, so if they want to buy the car at the end, they'll have the money saved up. So this question is really about how much would he have to deposit extra into some savings account to make the buyout in 3 years. And we'll assume that he starts with the down payment amount he would have used for his car in the savings account. So instead of making a down payment here, he opens a savings account, saves up some money every month with this annual interest rate in order to make $16,000 by the end. This is another question where we're going to have to use TVM. So let's hop over to our spreadsheet. I've gone ahead and calculated the rate, effective rate, number of years, and number of periods in the same way that we did before by dividing and multiplying by 12. Our present value in this case is going to be the amount of money that starts in the account, which is not zero, it's $7,000. At the end, we want to have the money for the buyout, which is $16,000. Now be careful, our present value here, this is the money we put into the account at the start, it's coming out of our pocket, so it has to be negative. The future value is going to be positive because that's the money we're taking out of the account to then go pay for our car for the buyout at the end. We can use TVM to solve for the payments we would make into this account, which is really how much you're saving every month, equals PMT, open bracket, our rate, number of periods, present value, future value, and the question said we're making it at the start of each month, which is a 1 at the very end, close our bracket, and we see that he would have to be saving about $202.23. If we wanted to compare how much he would be saving up each month for each case, in our leasing example, it would be $700 plus this $202 in order to make the buyout at the end, so a total of $902.23, whereas for our truck payments, it's only $808 per month. So it's about $22 less. So in terms of monthly amount, if you'd plan on making the buyout at the end, it's definitely a better idea to just buy the car at the start and make those payments. If you're unsure about it, leasing is a great option. Because you're making monthly payments and saving up for the buyout, if at the end of 3 years you decide you don't actually want the car, you've got $16,000 saved up. You can maybe look at purchasing a different vehicle, use it as a down payment for another vehicle, or use it to buy another vehicle perhaps. It really just depends on how committed you are to buying the vehicle, or if you want the flexibility. That's the end of our first video here on leasing. Stay tuned for the second video where we're going to be talking more about renting versus buying and going back to that mortgage calculator we used a little while back. See you then.